Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Off Campus. Kindly subscribe our channel Off Campus and support us. In this lecture we are going to solve some problems in control system. Previously we have solved many problems in control system. If you are not watching those video, kindly check with the playlist, and also I give you in the link in the icons which is running above the video. Okay, let's start the video. The second order system defined by 25 divided by s square plus 5s plus 25. Some transfer function is given as step input. The time taken for the output to settle within 2% of input is. We are going to find out the settling time for the given transfer function. So let's see how to solve this problem. What is the formula for settling time? Settling time equal to for 2%. There is a two different formula for settling time. Settling time for 2% and 5%. Here we need to find out the settling time for the 2%. So for 2%, 4 divided by zeta into omega n, where zeta equal to damping ratio and omega is the natural frequency. So the given transfer function, what is that? 25 divided by s square plus 5s plus 25. I told you now two different formula for settling time. For 2% error, 4 by zeta into omega n. For 5% error, in case of 5%, what is the settling time? Ts is equal to 5 divided by zeta into omega n. So here we need to find out for 2%. So this is the given transfer function. By comparing this transfer function with the standard second order transfer function, omega n divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega n into s plus omega n square. By comparing these, we need to find out the zeta value and omega n value and substitute this in this formula. We will find out the settling time for 2% of input. So what is omega n squared is equal to 25. So omega n is equal to 5 radians per second. Next, compare these two. 2 zeta omega n equal to 5. 2 into zeta into 5 is equal to 5. Substitute omega n value was 5. What we will get? 5 will cancel. Zeta is equal to 1 by 2. 1 by 2 we will get. Okay. Now we are going to substitute in that formula. 4 divided by for settling time. 4 divided by zeta into omega n. Zeta equal to 1 by 2 is nothing but 0.5. into what is omega? Omega n. Omega n is equal to 5. So by simplifying this, what we will get? 1.6 second. 1.6 second as settling time within 2% of input. So settling time for 2% is nothing but 1.6 second is equal to option A. 1.6 second is the right option for this problem. What is the next problem? Next problem is based on the Routh-Hurwitz criterion. The characteristic equation of a feedback control is 2s power 4 plus s cube plus 3s squared plus 5s plus 10 equal to 0. The number of roots in the right half of the S plane is. Four options are given. We need to find out the number of roots in the RHS plane. So from this characteristic equation, form the Routh-Hurwitz criterion. How to find out the Routh-Hurwitz criterion? S power 4, S cube, S squared, S power 1 and 2 S power 0. So form the Routh array table. Write the coefficient of S power 4 and even numbers 3 and 10. Here 1 and 5. There is no coefficient here. So 2, 3, 10, 1, 5. This is the Routh array table. we are going to find out the form the next how to find out 1 into 3 minus 5 into 2 divided by this term. 1 into 3 what is that? 1 into 3 I am simplifying here. 1 into 3 minus 5 into 2 divided by this one. This one we will get the same term. 1 into 3, 3 minus 10. 3 minus 10 is nothing but minus 7. So minus 7 here. Similarly, how to find out the roots for here? How to solve for here? 1 into 10, 2 into 0 for this column. 1 into 10 and 2 into 0 divided by this one here. 1 into 10 what? We will get 10. Minus 2 into 0, 0 divided by 1, 1. So what we will get? 10. 10 over here. Similarly, what we have to find out for this third column. Correct. For this row, what we will get? We no need to find out this. We can't simplify further. This is the this is the way to find out the next roots for in the root array. 1 into 3 minus 5 into 2 divided by this term we will get minus 7. Similarly for this, 1 into 10 minus 2 into 0 divided by this we will get 10. In short, whenever the 0 comes, just write the above the number, we will get the same number. We will get that number only. No need to simplify again. When 0 comes, just write the above the 0, what we will get? 10. What is above the 0 here? Number 10. Number 10. So just write it number 10 here. When we solving also, we are getting the same number here, same value here. So whenever 0 comes, no need to solve for it. Just write the above number of 0. What is above number of what is the number above 0? Just copy that number here. So in exam point of view, it will save our time. So no need to simplify, but we know how to simplify these roots. So just write the number above 0, 10. So similarly, for this root, we are going to multiply this with here. Minus 7 into 5, minus 10 into 1 divided by minus 7. Minus 7 into 5, minus 7 into 5, minus 10 into 1 divided by minus 7. What we will get by simplifying? Minus 35, minus 10 divided by minus 7. Some minus 45 divided by 7, minus 7. So 45 divided by 7, something we will get. 45 divided by 7, by simplifying what we will get? This is a positive number. No need to simplify this. 45 by 7 plus 45 by 7. There is nothing here. So I just write 0 here. So again, we are going to solve for to find out the value for s power 0. How to solve? 45 into 10 minus 7 into 0 divided by 45 by 7. What we will get? 10 only. No need to solve for this, simplify this, because just whenever 0 comes, just copy the above number. So 0, 10 here. Can we check it again? Can we check it again? Right. 45 by 7 into 10 minus 7 into 0. Minus of 7 into 0 divided by 45 divided by 7. So what we will get? This term minus 7 into 0 is 0 only. So 45 by 7 get cancelled. What we will get? Simply 10. So just copy the number above 0. It is enough to, no need to solve for further. So this is the first column we have simplified the first column. Just what is asked in the question? Number of roots in the right half of S plane. How to find out the number of roots in the right half of S plane? Whenever look into the first column, number of sign changes in the number of sign changes in the first column equal to number of roots in the right hand side column, right half of S plane. Number of sign changes in the first column is equal to the number of roots in the right half of S plane. This is the method to find out the roots of the right half of S plane. So look into the first column alone. First column alone. See the sign changes. See, this is positive. Positive to positive, no sign changes here. Positive to negative, so one sign change here. Positive to negative value, one sign changes. Again negative value to positive value, so another one sign changes. Here positive to positive only, so no sign changes. See carefully, this is negative value, negative value, negative minus 7. See from this, look into the first column alone. Positive to positive, no sign changes. Positive to negative, one sign changes. Again negative to positive, another one. So two sign changes. Here positive to positive, no sign changes. So how many sign changes here? Two sign changes here. So two sign changes is equal to the number of roots in the right half of S plane. How many roots here? Four roots are given. Total number of roots is four roots. So two sign changes is equal to the two roots are in the right half of S plane. So the answer for this is option A, 2. Number of sign changes is equal to number of roots in the right half of S plane. See, whenever looking into the first problem, we may have a chance of doing mistake. How? Seeing this sign, so only one sign changes, so the sign change is 1. So don't do like this. This is not a only one sign change. From positive to negative, one sign change. From negative to positive, another sign change. So number of sign changes is 2. So number of sign changes from the first term to last term, we have to be checked very carefully. Negative, positive to positive, no sign change. Again positive to negative, one sign change. Again negative to positive, another one. 1 plus 1, 2 sign changes. Again, positive to positive, no sign change. So, 1 plus 1, 2 sign changes. So, 2 sign changes. So, 2 roots in the right half of S plane. So, for this problem, option A, 2 is the right option for this problem. Let's move on to the next problem. What is that? The DC gain of a system represented by the transfer function 12 divided by S plus 2 into S plus 3 is 4 different options are given. We need to find out the DC gain. How to find out the DC gain for the given transfer function? DC gain. This is the given transfer function. T of S is equal to 12 divided by S plus 2 into S plus 3. See, it is T of S. Transfer function 12 divided by S plus 2 into S plus 3. So, how to find out the DC gain? DC gain is nothing but T of S at S is equal to 0. Substitute S equal to 0 and find out the value for the DC gain. 12 divided by 0 plus 2 into 0 plus 3. What we will get? 12 divided by 2 into 3. What we will get? 2. So, DC gain is equal to 2. Option B, 2 is the right option for this problem. Just substitute in place of 0 in place of S in the given transfer function, we will find the DC gain of a system. We'll move on to the next problem. The transfer function of a system given by T of S equal to 100 divided by S squared plus 20S plus 100. The system is four options are given. What is that? Overdamped, critically damped, underdamped and unstable. So we need to find out the system is overdamped or critically or damping of the system or stability. So how to find out that system? Just compare this transfer function with the, this is the given transfer function, 100 divided by s square plus 20s plus 100. Just comparing this transfer function with the general second order or standard second order transfer function. What is that? Omega n divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n squared. By comparing these, find out the zeta value. From this zeta value, we will have several conditions for this zeta value. From this zeta, we will find the which type of system the given transfer function is. So, what is omega n squared? Omega n squared equal to 100. So, what is omega n? Is equal to 10 radians per second. This is omega n value. Next, comparing 2 zeta omega n is equal to 20. Then 2 into zeta into omega n value is 10. 10 is equal to 20. So 2 into 10, 20, 20, 2 into 10, 20, 20 will get cancelled. So zeta value is 1. So zeta, whenever zeta value is 1, it is a critically damped system. So the given transfer function is option B. A critically damped system is the correct option for this problem. Whenever zeta value is 0 to 1, 0 to 1, the system is underdamped. When it is zeta value is equal to 1, it is critically damped. For overdamped, zeta value is greater than 1. For underdamped, zeta value will be 0 to 1. For critically damped, zeta value is equal to 1. So for this problem, the right option is option B, a critically damped system. So I will end up the video here. We'll solve the many problems on control system in our upcoming videos. So kindly subscribe our channel Off Campus and click on the bell icon. You will receive notifications and check with the playlist. I saved it in playlist under different categories of engineering, mathematics and electronics and communication subjects like microprocessor, digital signal processing and many subjects, communication system and digital electronics like that. So kindly check with the playlist. Thanks for watching.
Bye.